back to my channel. If you're new here, then please don't forget to press the subscribe button because I bring you Jesus-centric and hope-filled content every week. Well, first and foremost, before I begin today's vlog, I wanted to apologize to all of you for not uploading anything for the past 2 weeks. I was a little caught up with personal work, but I'm back. And today I just wanted to have a heart-to-heart conversation with you all. Just wanted to share a few post-lockdown thoughts that I've been sharing with the Father, and I've been trying to hear what the Holy Spirit has to say about it as well. So that's what I'm going to be talking about today. And if you're interested to find out what are these post-lockdown thoughts, then please watch this video till the end. So a few days ago, I remember I was just retrospecting and thinking about the time when the coronavirus pandemic had just begun and there was a lull, in the atmosphere. People were panicking and there was a sense of uncertainty that was looming over us. And it was at that time that I began to get a lot of messages from people about how they want to know more about Jesus and about his kingdom. And as and when we got more used to the pandemic and this uncertainty settled, their desire to know about Jesus settled as well. And, you know, they just didn't want to respond any further. And I think that really broke my heart to see that a lot of times what people were fearing was not really God. It was not the fear of God, which is the beginning of wisdom, but the fear of the virus or the fear of the pandemic. And that's when it hit me that a lot of times we actually use God as an SOS crutch that we go to when we are in a dilemma or when we are in a problem. And God is so sweet, he's so faithful, he always meets us in the point of our need. But I am reminded, and it's a very uncomfortable question, you know, are we like the 9 lepers? If you remember that episode where 10 lepers came to Jesus looking for healing, and Jesus healed all 10 of them, but only one came back to Jesus to thank him. And so it really makes me ponder and wonder if we are like those 9 lepers, or are we like that one leper, you know, who yes, comes to the Lord in the middle of the crisis, receives a breakthrough, and then also comes back to Jesus to thank him for what he has done? Or are we like the 9 lepers who receive our breakthrough, are all happy-go-lucky about it, and we just leave, never to come back to the Father? And so that is something that I've really been asking myself, and perhaps you can ask yourself that as well. I'm also reminded about certain interesting parables in the Bible. One was in the Gospel according to Luke, where it was the parable of the banquet, where there's like this dinner feast being thrown, and then the host, you know, sends out his servants to go and invite people. And a lot of people rejected the invitation because they had a breakthrough. Someone got married in the parable, somebody had to look after their farm. In other words, they were prospering, they had something to be grateful for. But that success, instead of drawing them closer to the presence of Jesus, took them away from the Lord. And so they rejected the invitation. And so I feel sometimes a lot of us are like that, you know, once we receive our breakthrough, who, Jesus? You know what? God? No. And so we just come to him when we need something. He becomes like this little raffle ticket that you fill in just to get that prize. And once you get the prize, you know, that's it. Your relationship with Jesus is over as well. Or perhaps, there's another very interesting parable of the foolish builder and the wise builder. So the wise builder, we all know, builds his house on the rock, and the foolish builder builds it on sand. And so when the storm comes, a storm of equal magnitude, I believe, strikes both of them. The wise builder is firm and the foolish builder loses everything he built because he built it on sand. And so I remember my pastor told me this once. He said, you can never build your house in the middle of the storm. In other words, you can't really build your intimacy with the Father after the storm has come. And we all know storms will come. We live in a fallen world. Jesus himself said, in this world you will have troubles, so troubles will come. But at that moment, you know, trying to listen to God and hear what he's saying becomes really difficult. I've been there, done that, and it's very tough. But if you have a history with God to look back at, and you have built your personal relationship, and you have testimonies of the goodness of God, so then even when calamities come, like the wise builder, you do not shake. And so I just want to tell you that, you know, we need to stop using God as an SOS plan that we go to just when we require something. God is faithful, even when we're not faithful. And so He will meet you at the point of your need. He'll give you what you need. But you know, I feel like there's so much more to the kingdom of Jesus. It's so much more than just receiving the blessings. It's so much more than just receiving your healing or your deliverance. I believe Jesus wants each one of us to become blessers, and He wants us to become healers and deliverers. And we're gonna get that only when we press on and we look for intimacy and relationship with the Father. We don't just seek the blessing, but we seek the blesser. And when you seek the blesser, you in turn also become a blesser. You become a blessing to the world. So I just want to urge you today. I mean, I believe we've all been guilty of doing that, falling back on God only as a crutch, only as an SOS, like I said, an SOS 101 sort of a phone number we go to when we're in problem. And that's great, but that's not the ultimate perfect plan of God that He has for you. So please press on. I know we all went all crazy about God and Jesus when the coronavirus, you know, just broke out, and something else will come up in the years ahead. And so at that point, what are you going to fall back on? So remember, don't just build a relationship with God in the middle of the storm, which is very tough. Build it even when life's good. You'll enjoy friendship, you'll enjoy intimacy with the Father. And like I said, don't just look after or go after the blessing, because Jesus wants you to become a blesser. He wants you to become a healer, and He wants you to become the deliverance for the world. You are God's breakthrough. And to become that, you just need to spend more time with God. Even when days are good and days are not so good, God is still good. So God bless you, and I hope you were blessed by this video. If you were, then please don't forget to share it. Comment below if you've been guilty of doing what I just talked about, using God as a 101 plan. And how did you build your relationship with God? How did you build a friendship with the Father? Share your thoughts on this, and let's be a blessing to the world. Remember, like I said, you are God's breakthrough for this world. God bless you, and have a great week ahead. If you liked this video, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel.